Cam Fowler with a left wing feed. Bucks in and deep. Elvis thought about going to play it and then decided to return to that goal crease. Rightfully so. Along the wall. Puck is punched ahead. Down the right wing. Moving in. Olivier with a shot. Scores! First shot. First goal. 1-0.
Nice play on the wall here. It's a chip to speed. A good job by Olivier to get his feet moving right away. And he elects to shoot the puck earlier. This has to be the attitude of the Blue Jackets. And what a shot it is. Look where that hits the corner, where the crossbar meets the post. World-class player.
Jackets on the kill.
Corrali, no stick right off that faceoff.
18th on the kill at 76.7% of the Jackets. Elvis with a couple of stops and he'll hold on here. In this opening period, if you've joined us late, Olivier at 217 with his third of the season on Columbus's first shot. Puck knocked down. Good effort there. Thrown to the near wall. Ducks look to clear. Turn it over. Rozenek scores. And it's 2-0. Two shots, two goals. The Columbus Blue Jackets lead. Scoring streak, picks up his first goal in 18 games.
Well, nice pressure here on the forecheck, and then a lucky bounce, and Rozenek here, he's going to go top shelf on Stolarz, right up top there, and as he gets the puck, you're right, you can see what he's thinking. He's not thinking pass back door to Kent Johnson. There's no hesitation at all.
To Rozenek. Here come the Jackets again. Marchenko, cross ice pass.
You'd think after seeing those two shots, he'd shoot that puck for Marchenko.
Here. Puck played on that right wing. Temperature never changes, always in the 70s.
Is that right?
Bemstrom across the line.
No good if you're a weatherman.
Branson tried to reach behind him, could not play it. Gus deals to the point for Blankenberg. Traffic in front of the net. There's a long shot that's blocked. Right back on a Nyquist stick and a bad save. By Stolarz. A rebound sent wide. Blankenberg on the half wall. Kent Johnson. Blankenberg steps up. Goes right to the net. Tried to tuck it home short side on Stolarz.
Got Blankenberg here.
Yeah, Blankenberg. Boy, small in stature, but plays with a big heart and plays physical.
Just perfectly timed hit there. Right into the bench.
Wow. Centering pass by Goodrow. That's Blankenberg again. Scores. And it's 3-0. A rush shot beats Stolarz. Columbus 3. Anaheim no score.
And then a few seconds later, Blankenberg loads up, leans on that stick, and Stolarz just can't keep up with it. Good hard shot. Just like the hit. Hard hit, hard shot.
Elvis will sweep it around the wall. We'll tell you about the Anaheim goaltending change here in a moment. Up on the wing, Terry centers and scores. So 22 seconds in here to period number two.
This is way too early for the Blue Jackets to give this up. It's a play through the neutral zone here that goes back the other way. It's really a simple play. But you can see as Gavrikov is up and Laine thinks the puck is going away from his own end. He's on the wrong side of Henrique, who gets in the middle of the ice, and he just perfectly times that puck in the top shelf off of the skate of Elvis Merzlikins.
And racing up ice. A pass here for Terry, looking to cut in. Fires a shot. Elvis the save. The rebound gathered up there by Sillinger. That's five of their six defensemen we've mentioned. Zegras to the goal line. Zegras. Oh, it played off the pad. Left wing and across the line. Strome coming in off the wing there in front. Oh, Elvis in the blue paint wisely. Goes down on a knee and covers up. Goodrow hanging on. Johnny Goodrow with a shot and it's blocked in front there. Ooh, that one went off Terry and he's in some difficulty there after blocking that shot on the right leg. Jackets block that and head up ice. Blankenberg leads the way. He'll dump it deep and then head to the bench.
Nice job by Peek and Blankenberg down in their own end. And Anaheim trying to find some time and space. They just can't do it with the bodies on them immediately.
Here they come again. Cross ice pass. Comtois. And it's into the net. And it's a 3-2 hockey game.
And they make it happen. You can see everyone's set in their space. And that middle lane drive of Fowler, he's a defenseman. He pulls the Blue Jackets defenseman a little bit lower. And that opens a passing lane. But how about the play by Comtois? He's on one knee. And it's a backhand saucer pass. And then who's the defenseman right there? It's Fowler.
Jackets have got it on the right wing wall. Tim Birney steps up across the line. Birney straight through. And Gibson forced to make a big stop off that left pad from center. Puck is dumped in. Elvis tried to play it. Henrique. On there for Terry. Terry to the point. Scores. It's 3-3. Benoit with a bullet. And the Ducks come from a 3-0 first period deficit to tie it here in the second with less than five to go.
But it's a hard work down low by the Ducks. Benoit's in the middle of your screen. There's no one on him. You can see two players on one there in the top left of your screen. That leaves Benoit wide open. Now, did Elvis Merzlikins get bumped before that puck went in the net? And that's what Brad Larson's taking a look at here. Was he interfere with and not able to make that save because the big body? There's some details of this game they want to work on. I'm sure it was talked about in that second intermission. I expect more checking by the Blue Jackets to get pucks back quicker out of their own end and then attacking Gibson.
Shot at the, no, it was a pass. The net was gaping wide open. Elvis trying to get into position and it trickled wide. Unwise move there by Elvis. And here, never really set a high shot off his glove. And disgustingly, he bangs his goal stick and then flips the puck into the corner. Never really settled after coming out.
He's tied up in front with his own player all over him. And then Zegras, not sure if that got deflected or what. Looked like it might have changed out right there. But you see, Elvis just takes a swat.
There were 72 multi-goal comeback victories. 72, they were on a pace for 160 plus. The record, the NHL record is 138.
Just a little outside of the mark.
Kent Johnson, precious seconds remain, less than 10. Gibson on the edge of the blue paint will hold.
He's used to a lot of pucks on net.
Three shots for Anaheim on the power play. There's Peak trying to gather that puck up and move forward. On the wing in front. A loose puck and scores. Jones followed up on the initial attempt by Lundestrom. And now Anaheim lead by two.
It's going to be this play at the line. Looked like the Blue Jackets were going to get that puck out over the line. And this, Elvis didn't know where that puck was after. You could see he was kind of surprised, thought he had it locked on the left side of his body. Two Blue Jackets down there on the left side of the corner. That puck is left there. And you can see Gabranson gets boxed out. Smart play by Magna. Magna 7 here. Actually, didn't even know he was there. He ran into Gabranson.
As you mentioned, then a bit of a slump. No goals. He's getting assists, picking up points, including a couple tonight, but not able to score. And Law throws it in front. Down is Elvis and picks it up with the blocker. As the final seconds come off the clock, and the Columbus Blue Jackets, despite a 3-0 lead, allow Anaheim five straight goals and a 5-3 victory.